It's Out with the Old at IBM and a good old boys club at One Market Research Company. Plus, will the military finally be held accountable for sexual harassment? I'm Erica Domingo, and this is a Toxic Workplace Report. So let's dive right in. Ageism at IBM. In a world where race, gender, and sexual orientation discrimination have taken the forefront, age discrimination is still a big issue in workplaces across the country, despite the fact that it's had protections in place for over 50 years. A lawsuit brought by the EEOC in New York brings strong allegations of systemic age discrimination at IBM. The EEOC uncovered evidence that over the past 7 years, IBM has had a top-down policy of eliminating older workers in favor of young new hires. In 2018, IBM sought to prevent its chief diversity officer from making a move to Microsoft, a direct competitor, arguing that she had confidential and trade secret information. Instead, what was discovered is that the information she had was discussions about getting young people into the workforce and getting rid of the older workers. The reporter who first broke the story in 2018 has been quoted as saying, "Age bias is so deeply seated in IBM and American corporate culture that it's questionable whether the EEOC determination and eventual payout will change things." Sex in the military under fire. In the wake of the death of Army Specialist Vanessa Guillen, over 70 lawmakers are co-sponsoring a bill that will make sexual harassment and sexual assault in the military a crime. Guillen's death has highlighted once again that sexual harassment in the military often goes unpunished and therefore remains unreported by individuals who fear retaliation by their superior officers. Proponents of the bill hope to curb sexual harassment and thereby sexual assault by making it a criminal offense. An advisor with the Women's Veterans Social Justice Network states, "Sexual harassment is a lead-up because these are crimes of power and control in an environment that prides itself on good order and discipline." The bill also seeks to remove prosecutorial and investigative authority from the chain of command in light of the fact that many young women in the military are often harassed by their superior officers. Yet another good old boys club. Market research company Information Resources, Inc. is under fire for discrimination against women and people of color in a new lawsuit brought in federal court in New York. The lawsuit cites statistical evidence that women are paid 5 to 10% less than their male colleagues, and there is a lack of women amongst leadership at the company, including on the executive committees and the board of directors. One of the lead plaintiffs in the proposed collective action alleges that she was terminated after raising complaints about the failure to promote women within the workplace, and then was subsequently replaced by two men making 10% more than her. Although the company has been vocal about diversity in the wake of George Floyd's death, the lawsuit alleges that diversity is, quote, the last thing that IRI cares about. Here at Grungo Colorulo, we're still mourning the loss of legal giant Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. But we have hope for the future in that we, alongside many of our colleagues, are still fighting for equality in workplaces across the country. Thanks for watching this week's Toxic Workplace Report. If there's a toxic tale you think we should cover, leave it in the comments below.